carrying years of resentment, carrying years of sadness and anger, and the burden of feeling like you need to be there for them, like you need to feel just as bad as they do. Blessings and blessings. What's up, y'all? You ever have one of those things that comes up for you that's so pressing that you can't wait? Like, I'm at a car wash right now, waiting for my car, but this message had to be said, and it felt like it wasn't just for me. Do you ever just feel like you're being used? That's sort of like what comes up for me sometimes. I get these hits where it's like, now, do it now. Not next week, not when you have the fancy camera, not when everything is aligned, but now. And so I wanted to pop in here and talk about one of the biggest lessons of my entire life. It's something I'm still working through, working with, and at times I'm doing it masterfully, and at times I'm not. This has been on my heart to share, and it came through today again, and I was like, game time. The message and the reminder and the lesson that I'm still sitting in, still learning, still being with, is the art of caring but not carrying. You see, I've recognized that, I guess you would call me a bleeding heart, where when somebody's going through something or anything, I take it personal. I care so much that I end up carrying it with me into other aspects of my life. This is deeply detrimental because we are vibrational beings, which means that we attract from our way of being. And so if I'm carrying someone else's pain, someone else's anger, someone else's burden, then I am not available for the creativity, the power, the harmony, the joy, the presence that the Creator has gifted me. And so I felt like I needed to say this to remind some of you that are carrying other people's stuff and carrying years of resentment, carrying years of sadness and anger and the burden of feeling like you need to be there for them, like you need to feel just as bad as they do. I have family members that are basically every other week going through it. And for a long time, I used to feel like I needed to feel their stuff too. If they were sad, I needed to be sad. If they were depressed, I needed to be depressed. But the game is legitimately to care, but not to carry. And here's the distinction, right? So sympathy says, I feel sorry for you. Empathy, which is what I'm playing with at times, says, I feel what you're feeling. Compassion says, I see what you're being with, but I'm going to keep my conversation. I'm going to keep my frequency. I'm going to keep my love, my joy. I'm going to keep the sanctity and the spirit that I was born with upstairs. So you feel what you're feeling and I see what you're feeling, but I'm not going to carry it with you. Rah. Like, let that land. You know, when I was doing practitioner training in religious science, we had a practice called Bless the Mess, where we would watch the news and we would watch and be with what was happening in society. But instead of like feeling it, and here's a prime example. I turned on my YouTube today and it said, black man shot 22 times by the cops in Oakland, California in a Taco Bell parking lot. And I felt my body retract. I felt the years of pain and suffering. I felt what it feels like to be a dark-skinned black male and have people afraid of you. Cross the other side of the street, clutch their purses, get out of the elevator, follow you around grocery stores because they think you're gonna steal something. I know what that feels like. And so I watched my body go into this space, and then I remembered that I get to care but not carry, because I am of no service to humanity if I'm feeling all the pain. If my vibration is low, if I'm feeling everything, then I am not of service. because there is something that each and every one of us was born with that can never be taken away from us, that is only and uniquely ours to give. And so it is our duty as world citizens, as sacred vessels and containers for the Almighty, whatever that is to you, it is our duty to honor that thing and say yes, to hold the high watch, to keep our conversations and our consciousness upstairs, even when stuff feels really bad, or it looks really bad, or you care so much that you feel like you need to save everybody. Mother Teresa said she walked through the streets of Calcutta seeing the face of God everywhere she went, and that is my practice. My quest is to have my life be a prayer, where everywhere I move, everywhere I go, I see the face of God in the roses and in the building, in the sludge on the ground back there, and in my own face. Like, whoa, let it freaking land. Are you guys feeling me right now? Or is this going over some heads? This message came back to me, and this is the biggest lesson I've been working with my whole life, and even in relationship with Alexi, even in relationship with my mom, my dad, just let it just water off of a duck's back, caring, but not carrying. This distinction will change your life, even if you just bring it in once a day. What am I carrying? What load am I holding? What boulders do I have in my backpack that do not belong to me? Oof. Oh man, that is so real. Blessings and blessings, y'all. I love you so much. From a gas station getting my car washed. If this resonated, please tag somebody. Just tag a few people. Share it, tag somebody. Love you all. Blessings and blessings. Hurrah! Let's get it.